in Minnesota.
He's got a fat ass.
He got a wide base.
Power of the big board. Board knows. Last year we nailed the Patriots' first round selection on the offensive line, and that's what we're doing today. Big board is back. So we got we did guards and centers earlier in the program. You can catch that at 985thesportshub.com or on the app. Alex Barth is going to give you a serious scouting report on all these guys. When we're done, he does a bang-up job on that as well on the web. Again, the Felger Mazz Big Board is brought to you by the Peterson School. An exclusive – this is the worst – is Moscatel is challenged on his best day. Is he now on acid? This is literally what's written in my copy. You ready?
Yeah, go. I don't think he writes this one.
Listen, brought you by the Peterson School, !! Felger and Mazz's draft board and exclusive draft coverage is brought to you by the Peterson School. Enroll for the summer at petersonschool.com. No punctuation. We teach the trades. Yeah. !! Peterson School has been a longtime sponsor of the Big Board. Thank you for the folks at the Peterson School. Never mind our copy. Okay, I got the Lindy Sports Annual back open here, attached to a big piece of cardboard. These guys are chucking little Nerf footballs at me with markers attached to the nose of them.
These are sneaky big throws.
Okay, this is a big position to need.
Yeah, right. This could be the first rounder.
So there's three pages of tackles. We're going to do all three pages. So throw well. Murray goes first. He throws like my Aunt Gertrude. Go ahead, Murray.
Murray's throwing yellow.
Hit the board.
Brought you two by.
Go. Ooh, good throw, Murray.
I think I got that orange box.
The blue box.
It was the green box.
The page on the right.
Yeah. The blue box, the green on the right.
The orange box in the left-hand side.
Huh?
No, he hit this one.
Thank you. Okay.
Are you blind?
Yes.
Okay, so that's closest to is Blake Freeland, BYU.
Oh, no shot.
6'8", 307.
Well, wait a minute.
Okay, we're going to read to you the bios here coming up. Okay, we'll just put the names on the board now.
They love tall guys to play left tackle.
And then we'll come back to it.
Okay, big magic underwear.
Blake Freeland of BYU.
You
got it. Ah, very good, Murray.
I didn't hear you.
I'm going with the green Sharpie. Color money!
Okay, again, you got to tell me where it lands because sometimes it's hard for me to see. Go ahead.
Okay, you ready?
Yep.
Yeah. Oh.
Yeah, that's
the
shaded. I see it. I got it. Oh, Richard Courage, not Courage, C-G-O-U-R-A-I-G-E, Courage.
Richard, well, that's a kind of chicken, I think.
Richard Courage from Florida.
Put him on the board. I'll give you one more page here. Stand by.
It's like pick on someone your age.
Courage, correct. Okay, Murray.
Okay.
Throw it well, my friend.
Murray, go. Let it go. Let it fly.
Hit that blue shaded
top
box.
Left, yeah,
blue
I box. See it. No, good shot. Zion Nelson of Miami.
Woo! Okay, I like him.
Thank you.
Another one. No blood in the water. No injuries. Nothing broken.
Yeah,
let's start with Zion Nelson, Miami.
Okay.
6'5", 311. His overview said he was once billed as a potential top 10 selection.
There you go.
Nelson was derailed by both injuries and a lack of continual development.
Good value.
All right, strengths. Great size and length with an impressive 84-inch wingspan at his disposal.
There you go. They love the guys with the long arms at left tackle.
Massive. High-effort player who will drive his legs and stay active in the run game.
What does that mean, high effort? Like he has to work harder? Because he sucks?
I think he's got a lot of effort. I think this is a strength, Matt, so this is a good thing.
Oh, all right, sorry.
Plenty strong and should continue to improve in that regard once he reaches an NFL weight room.
A little skinny.
Weaknesses. Missed most of the 2022 season due to an injury and will be facing major questions about his health from NFL teams.
Good value.
Average burst and long speed will make it hard to win in space. He slips off blocks too easily for a player with his size. Hands are a bit slow and wide.
He's got wide hands.
I never heard wide hands.
Isn't that a good thing?
What does that mean?
That means from the top of your thumb to the top of your pinky.
They're too wide.
Yeah, too wide.
Why would you want? Wouldn't you want wide hands as a tackle?
He's got frisbees for hands.
The hand placement is important. Edward Scissors hands there. Poor guy.
It's like some sort of alien.
Let's see. Angles are lackadaisical, and he isn't efficient with his steps.
Lax angles, bad steps, wide hands.
Put this guy with the wide hands on the board. Zion Nelson, Miami.
Oof. That was Murray's?
Yeah.
That
yeah.
Was
okay.
Sucked. That guy sucks.
Richard.
Guy, your guy sucks.
Richard Gourage. G-O-U-R-A-I-G-E. Richard Gourage?
Gourage.
Strengths. Savvy with his hands.
Oh, yeah. There you go. He makes his way around the bedroom.
Hey, now.
Next thing you know, oh, how'd that get in there?
Savvy with his hands and won't overcommit. Sturdy in pass protection.
Like it.
Able to keep his footing and angles, even when his hips and hands are working opposite of each other.
Yeah. He's doing the floss. He's flossing.
It's like the yeah.
Flosses at left tackle.
Even when his hips and hands are working opposite of each other. Natural power generator as a run blocker. Stays composed.
Ooh.
Even when his hands are getting batted out of the way.
While he's moving in the wrong direction.
Yeah. His hips are all over the place.
Seriously?
Stay away from me. Okay.
Weaknesses. Average quickness and agility will lead some teams to view him as an offensive guard.
Yep.
Has some lower body stiffness. Don't say anything, Mazz. That limits his flexibility.
I didn't say a word.
Lacks ideal length for an offensive tackle and will get caught at the end of long arm moves.
They're not picking this bum.
Long arm moves.
I was just going to say, how big is he?
6'5", 308.
Not big enough.
Okay.
6'5", and he's only 308?
He's projected in the fifth round. Just so you know, the first guy, Zion Nelson's predicted in the fifth round as well. So those are two real
reaches.
Yeah, which, you know, watch out. Here comes the Patriots.
Here we go. Here's page one.
Okay. Blake Freeland, BYU. One of the most decorated athletes in Utah high school history. It's kind of a low bar.
I was just going to say, what does that mean? That's like being good in Rhode Island.
Freeland did a little bit of everything, or Connecticut, in high school. He won the state championship in multiple sports and set records in the shot put and javelin. Who cares?
Oh, great. He's a good shot putter.
Strengths. Rare 35-inch arms are a difference maker when it comes to snagging and redirecting edge rushers.
35-inch long?
Or like the 35-inch python.
Or biceps.
Like Hogan.
Yeah, does he have like 35-inch biceps?
What is it, Barth? It can't be 35 inches in circumference of a bicep.
It's length.
Yeah, it's the length of the arm.
Well, that's not that long. Mine are 33.
How do you know?
What sleeve do you have in a shirt?
I never thought of it.
You sure you do? Like a 35-inch sleeve isn't that long. 35-inch arms. It has to be a bicep. Has to be.
What were the pythons on Hogan back in the day, Jimmy?
24 inches, brother.
Yeah, so maybe he's got 10 inches on Hogan.
This guy's got tree trunks for arms.
Well, the Lindy.
Yo, guys, Hulk Hogan here, and I've got one question for the Sports Hub listeners out there. What you gonna do when Felger and Mazz run wild on you, brother? What you gonna do?
Greatest piece of sound we have.
Seriously, wait, this is strengths?
Strengths. Rare 35-inch arms are a difference maker when it comes to snagging and redirecting edge rushers.
That's got to be the length of his arms. That doesn't feel that long.
Brick wall and pass protection when he settles his feet and frames up opponents.
A TiVo maniac.
You got like Francis Ford Coppola.
Plays much sturdier than expected for his weight. He's 6'8", 307. Yeah, that does feel kind of slight. Good build-up speed when he gets rolling downhill. Deceptive athlete with unique balance and core strength through contact. Weaknesses.
They're not taking this clown.
What you gonna do?
Leverage can be an issue at times. Settles high in his stance and isn't flexible enough to get much lower.
Exactly. Well, he's 6'8", 300 pounds. No wonder he doesn't have any leverage.
Can't get down.
He's tall and skinny.
Can't get down.
He's gonna get plowed over by in the NFL.
Feet can lag behind his hands.
Oh my God, this guy sucks.
When dealing with twitchy opponents. Starts to get clunky when he has to adjust on short notice.
Where's he projected?
Starts to get clunky when he has to adjust on short notice?
If they get any of these three tackles, Mac Jones is going to get killed.
Okay, well, what can I tell you? The board knows. Put him on the board.
Where's he projected? Tell me where he's projected.
Third round.
Oh, that seems high.
Okay, well, Barth again will give you the real lowdown, the real skinny on 98.5thesportshub.com. What do you think of these guys?
I wouldn't take a tackle from BYU. Our tackle group sucks.
Well, what can I tell you?
Yeah, Barth, is it any good? The tackle group, give us hand signals.
Thumbs up.
Something.
Thumbs seriously. Up, thumbs down. Just I give me something.
I like Wright, who they have listed as a guard. I think he's a really good tackle. That would be the guy for me.
Wright? Who's that?
Wright, you got him in the first group, the kid from Tennessee.
Oh, yeah. Oh, no. Oh, the guard from earlier in today.
Oh, you think he's a tackle.
He's a tackle, yeah. He's a tackle. Some people think he's going to go in the first round.
Okay, well, there you go. So listen to the earlier in the day if you want to know the
good. Doesn't say much for these three guys.
No, these guys, these three clowns, forget about it. But put them on the board. Hour to go. Your thoughts on the impending doom facing the Boston Bruins coming your way right after Murray gets you updated. 90 seconds, no commercials.
What you gonna do?
WBCS 51 Boston. From the Town Fair Tire Studios. The home.